it's Renee coming at you with a quick little workout today. We haven't done one for a while, so I, as you can tell, I'm glistening because I already worked out. But I'm going to work out with you, and I want to share with you about I'm struggling with some lymphedema. I'm feeling it building up now, and it builds up along in here and along in here, so my arm, it struggles. So I'm doing my workout, and you're supposed to do heavy weights as heavy as you can do. In lateral moves, I can't do as much weight as I would like to. Some days I do better, some days are like today and they're struggling. So anyway, we're going to work through that, and I'm going to show you how I modify, which is with a lighter weight. But I really pay attention to my form, and I try to make it feel like it's heavier than it is. So first, we're just going to march in place, okay? Just a nice, slow, steady workout. And get our heart rate up and get our muscles warmed up, our body warmed up a little bit. Just a nice march in place here. So if you have weights, hopefully you have them handy. I should have mentioned that first. You know, even a can of soup, something to add some type of resistance or a physical reminder to add resistance, okay? Because you can do it without weights and create your own resistance in your muscles by flexing them. All right, make sure your abs are in, okay? And you're breathing, chin is up. And if your lymphedema is acting up, you don't have to swing that arm quite as much as the other one. And let's neck punch. Shoulders warmed up. And we're going to swing them as much as we can. See, I have limited mobility there. It really is odd because when it starts acting up, it feels like my armpit is swollen and my side kind of feels like it's swollen and going numb. It's kind of crazy. All right, keep those legs moving and those arms moving, shoulders moving, because we're going to work them a little bit tonight. And I want to get a little bit of your lower body warmed up as well, because we're going to do some squats. So we're going to do some squats now, okay? Now squats, you guys know the deal, right? Let's see if I can get where you sit. Your knees, your booty goes all the way back. Woo! Knees are not going past those toes. So important to remember that. Down for three, two, three. And up. One, two, three. Up. You should be able to pick your toes up. You hold your arms down here if you need to, okay? Let's go back to singles. Woo! And single. And single. Alright. I think we're warm up enough. It's hard for me to tell because I'm warm. Alright, bend your knees if you're going to pick up any kind of weights. Again, like I said, you could use 1 pound. You can use 1 pound weights. I'm going to use 3 because this is where I'm modifying at. You can use cans of soup, bottles of water, or nothing at all. Just make sure that you're thinking about the form and contracting those muscles. Oh, my arm is sore. All right, so I want you to have your feet hip distance, hip width distance apart. Knees are lined up with your ankles, okay? Because we're going to squat, and when we're going to squat, we're going to do a lateral raise. So lateral means out to the side, okay? Now, very important is your form. Your tummy needs to be tucked in, okay? Like you're pulling that belly button towards your spine. You're remembering to breathe. Your shoulders are relaxed. It's hard and difficult because of the lymphedema in my arm. But we're going to squat, and when we squat, we're going to lift laterally. And I want you to lead with your elbow, okay? If your hand is coming up here, it's not right, okay? It should be even, okay, with your shoulder. But lead with that elbow, okay? So we're going to go squat. Up, and knees slightly bent, abs are in, leading with those elbows, okay, and squat nice and slow, slow and steady, don't have to move and swing those arms around, and you'll find that when you're going slow like this, these 3 pound weights feel more like 5 to 8 pound weights, right? So lead with those elbows out. Shoulder height. Now see, my left shoulder I struggle with. And that's okay. It's just wherever you're at in your recovery process. Some days I do really well. And then some days I really, really struggle and I fight with myself to exercise. And most of the time I lose and I don't work out and I don't eat right. It's a constant fight, isn't it? And it's good to have those days. It's alright to take those days, a rest day, and eat what you want and enjoy life. And it's good to enjoy yourself on a regular basis, too. But, as you know, being cancer fighters, we really have to work hard at trying to stay as healthy as possible, because now our immune system's been compromised, right? Our energy levels have been knocked out of us. And our mental struggle is huge. And exercise, getting oxygen throughout your body and your lungs and your brain, help. Lymphedema swelling can really act up, but if you're taking care of yourself, doing the physical therapy your doctor prescribed, working out, it's really going to help cut that incidence back, hopefully. We're going to do two more, and then we're going to do a functional move, okay, with more squats. Sorry, guys. I won't keep you much longer, I promise. Let's do one more. And we're going to do an overhead press here, okay? So, again, I want you to squat, all right? Hands up here. So, squat. And then overhead press, like you're trying to put a box up on a shelf, okay? It's what they call a functional move. We use this move in our everyday life when we're trying to put something on that top shelf, trying to reach for something. You're pushing that box up on that shelf. Breathing, aren't you? Right? Right? We got two more right here, guys. Just two. Slow, slow, slow. Let's slow it down. See? Now it's tougher. Now those weights feel much heavier. Slow, slow, slow. Hold it here and count it down slow. 4, 3, 2, 1. Whoo, and relax. All right, okay. So let's do a tricep press. Again, this is going to be working back of this muscle, which is where my lymphedema acts up. In fact, it's incredibly numb right now and swollen. So I'm going to put both weights together, but you can just use one if you need to. Knees slightly bent and relaxed. Elbows up against your head, next to your ears. Okay? And you want to keep those abs tucked in. Keep that pelvis tucked in so that your back doesn't round out. Okay? You're breathing. And sorry, chin is up. And I need to slow this down for the last five. Ready? 1, 2, 3, 4. 4, 3, 2. One. Let's do four more. 4, 3, 2, 1. 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay, you feeling that? 1, 2, 3, 4. 4, 3, 2, 1. We got two more. 4, 3, 2, 1. 1, 2, 3, 4. One more set. 1, 2, 3, 4. 4, 3, 2, 1. All right. Slowly release them. Always bend your knees when you're putting your weights down. And let's stretch it out, okay? So we're going to stretch to the side. Booty goes back. Stretching out the inner part of the thigh because we worked a little bit at that for our squats we did. Breathe through it. And the other side. us up with a sumo squat. A shoulder stretch. And on the other side. And if you can, lean forward. Try to grab those toes and stretch out the backs of your legs and your hamstrings and your glutes. All right, you guys, thanks for joining me, and I'm going to try to get some more videos up for Cancercise, and I love you guys, and I want you to remember, right, you are stronger. Have a good night.